Top 10 Pets That Ate Their Owner. As we all know, pets can sometimes turn against the humans they call family. Even with training and domestication, some still manage to attack or eat their human caretaker. The sad part is that this issue occurs most often when dealing with exotic animals which are very difficult to train, such as lions, bears, and snakes, for example. These stories of devoted pet owners attempting a feat impossible, taming a wild beast, typically end in tragedy too many times over. And there's plenty more where those came from, so stay seated because in today's video, we are going to show you 10 animals that ended up eating their owners. Number 1. Scarface the Pitbull mauled his owner over a sweater. Brenda Guerrero, 52, and her family were accosted by Scarface the dog after she tried to make him wear a sweater. In Tampa on New Year's Day in 2017, Brenda attempted this, but Scarface turned his aggression from the woman who had been trying since Thanksgiving to get him into one of these sweaters for their cold weather. Not that we really experienced it just yet. When he went up against her husband, Ismael Chu, the 22-year-old son stepped in but was unable to stop them both being bitten as they managed somehow escape, leaving behind an agitated, pretty aggressive sounds like an understatement, pitbull outside. Animal control officers eventually arrived with tasers which subdues any animal, I guess. Unfortunately, Scarface was later put down. However, there is no news as to whether he was wearing his sweater when he died. This situation could have easily been avoided had Brenda not tried her hand at dressing an animal that wasn't hers in human item of clothing, instead of taking it back to the store and asking for a refund or trying. Number 2. Teddy the Black Bear killed his owner while she cleaned his cage. For over a decade, the Waltz family had raised their 350-pound black bear Teddy since it was just a cub. But even so, Kellyanne Waltz paid with her life when she made the mistake of cleaning his cage while he was still in it, as seen by children next door who watched from afar and saw him attack her to death. When authorities arrived, they found that Ted's husband's license for keeping exotic animals had expired long ago, thus leading them to believe this must have been what set off poor old Teddy too. This situation could have been avoided if the Waltz family hadn't attempted to clean Teddy's cage while he was in it. The Waltz family should have waited until Teddy was out of the cage before cleaning it. There was clearly not enough thinking going on. Number 3. A hoarder was bitten by his pet black widow. In Dortmund, Germany, a German man spent his solitude with only the company of spiders and snakes. It was one such spider that caused him to perish as it fed on him while he lay in his apartment for 2 weeks. The black widow had webbed across parts of Vogel's body when he was found by authorities, who then discovered countless other insects feeding on bits scattered around the room where they were living together until their food source ran out. Yikes, that sounds like something out of a Freddy vs. Jason movie. Number 4. Humphrey the Hippo ate his owner. In 2011, former South African Army Major Maurice Els was savagely bitten by his pet hippopotamus. After the animal had been rescued from a flood and adopted as a companion at age 5 months old, it only took another year for him to be viciously attacked while being tamed. "Humphrey's like my son," said Els earlier in the year before he attempted domestication with Humphrey once more, this time without success. It seems that even after all these years since adoption, when they were both just babies together who could not yet do any damage on their own volition, Humphrey is still capable of doing plenty himself. Break out repeatedly from his pen, chase golfers across courses, attack humans. Number 5. Simba the Pet Lion bit his owner. Illinois resident Al Abel kept a brood of exotic animals in a small zoo he called Cougar Bluff Enterprise, including one nearly 400-pound African lion. He was usually careful with his pets, but when cleaning its cage on that fateful day, it all went wrong. The door to Simba's secondary pen was left open for too long and tragically, state inspectors had to shoot him down before he could escape into Chicago suburbs. The lion roamed free, becoming more and more agitated. When police came to the farm, it refused to back down until they shot Simba dead with assault rifles. They found Abel's body near the animal cage after he bled out from a bite in his leg caused by the same big cat we all know as Simba. Number 6. A pit viper bit its owner. When she was only 15, Alexandria Hall managed to acquire a very rare species of snake that is native in Colombia. She had it shipped over and kept the dangerous creature inside her home for 12 years with no one being aware of its presence. But after biting this innocent woman, who had never even been bitten before herself by any venomous animal or human being, people finally knew where the snake lived as they raided her house, discovering an assortment wild animal, including 11 unmistakable vipers, just like what bit Miss Hall, dead on January 4, 2004. 4 days shy from celebrating her 46th birthday. Number 7. A farmer was devoured by his pet pigs. Family members of Oregon farmer Terry Vance Gardner were shocked to discover his dentures and undisclosed body parts in his pig enclosure several hours after Gardner went missing. Authorities think Gardner either suffered cardiac arrest and fell into the pen, or was knocked over by the huge animals before being eaten. The investigation dragged on for months and never produced a conclusive verdict as to whether the animals killed Gardner or simply ate him after he passed on. In a strange addendum to the story, police later raided Gardner's farm and arrested his son on multiple drugs and weapons violations. Number 8. A man kept a tiger in a tiny apartment. Anton Yates lived in a small apartment on Harlem's bleak streets. But this didn't stop him from buying and raising two exotic animals, an alligator and a tiger. In September 2003, he was taken to the hospital due to injuries that were most likely caused by his pit bull rather than either of these creatures. However, authorities kept their suspicions about Antoine because many people living near him knew exactly which creature lurked within his humble abode with them. Yet none reported it, except for one person who complained about fluids coming through her ceiling. Both pets would be captured at some point in time until they could eventually live out their days peacefully as long-lost friends. Number 9. A man was eaten by his pet lizards. Ronald Huff loved his pet lizards, and this sentiment was reciprocated when he died of natural causes in 2002, leaving behind a hoarder's den full of exotic creatures. The Nile monitor lizard, which only eats small animals like rabbits or squirrels, but not humans, feasted on the deceased for days until police found them still chomping away at Mr. Huff's corpse nearly 2 weeks after initial discovery. He had so many pets that it is hard to say exactly how they all managed without him. Number 10. A pet chimp terrorized the French family. Pepe the chimpanzee was French singer Léo Ferrer's pet and acted like an ordinary family member. But unlike other beloved pets, Pepe threw tantrums, terrorized house guests, kidnapped a human baby before they finally had to put him down after he suffered from a fall. In the autobiography of Léo Ferrer, he talks about his beloved chimpanzee Pepe. He recounts many stories from her life and how she would terrorize house guests to bite his stepdaughter when they were living in a small apartment together before finally being put down after falling off something and injuring herself. Wow, from spiders to chimps, animals can be comforting and certainly evil at times. I bet the next time you're in the pet store, you'll think twice about which furry friend you decide to bring home. So what do you think about today's video? Did it make you cringe? If so, let us know in the comments section below.